I began looking at armed conflict, and I began my research agenda around civil wars as a result of a study abroad experience that I had as an undergrad. And I was surprised to see these gang members and to understand their stories and to listen to their stories. And that, alongside with starting to learn Swahili, reshaped how I conceptualized of things like governance or the state and even the agency of local actors on the ground. I moved to Congo not because I was interested in studying civil war, but because I was interested in understanding people's experiences of post-conflict and of healing and of restoration in the aftermath of war. And it was through those encounters that I began to ask questions. The pathway to studying civil war and armed conflict was not just motivated by reading a book about civil war and wanting to go study these organizations, but was through this pathway of lived experience and interactions with good teachers in the field. In the classroom, students will get to engage and touch firsthand what a rebel bank statement looks like. And to bring in like a tangible artifact like that allows students to expand their ideas, not only about what armed groups are, to expand beyond ideas of armed groups as just thugs in the jungle with a gun, to more sophisticated organizations. And it also, I think, helps Notre Dame students to think about what agency on the international scale looks like, and to look at armed groups and people around the world as critical players in their own right. And so being able to provide students with real world firsthand materials from conflict zones and to put them in the position of needing to be the analysts also gives a firsthand take of how complicated some of these conflicts can be. I think is an invaluable opportunity to interact with and train the next generation of leaders, and to also feed back into the research communities. For me, peace studies means whose voices are we bringing to the table, and whose voices are we allowing to set the agenda of the work and to define what constitutes peace and what constitutes conflict.